God bless you, brother.
On the banks of the river,
old ship of Zion, she's long been sailing.
Looked out over life's troubled sea, there I saw it all, dear but failing. Is that the but the old ship kept sailing. Is that the old ship of Zion I seen? As the sun of the shield is my captain. Homeboard, I'll be living all my trouble and heartache lay behind. I'll be living with Jesus, the captain.
Haven't done that in a long time. Haven't thought about it. I know that.
Beautiful job.
That
thank you, Lord.
Made me think about when one of these days we'll step on board. It won't be no ship. We'll be stepping on board in the clouds of glory to meet the Lord in the air. And we'll leave all our heartaches and all our trouble. All the pain, all the worry, it all laid behind. And all this trouble that we face here, I'm so glad that it just remains here. And I'm glad that, very well, the Lord made a way for me. And I'm sure He made a way for all of you here. He made a way for you to be here.
Been wonderfully
today.
Blessed, Brother Jeremiah.
Yes, we are. We're blessed by the grace of God. We're blessed. Every one of us are blessed to be here, be able to sit together and love one another, be able to see each other here. But one day after a while, one by one, our seats might empty, Brother Dana, but we'll get to meet again. Amen. That made me think about that little boy of David. When he left here,
he can't come back.
Yeah, he can't come back here, but he can go and see him. I look forward for that day to happen. The other day, we were talking about loved ones and families looking. I sat down and I, for some reason, I have my grandfather on my mind, my papa, Herb. He's bored every one of us grandchildren to death. He loved us to no end. And the tears began to roll down my eyes, remembering that Mark had put on Facebook of us sitting around during Christmas time. But nevertheless, that He's left the testimony, He's left the light in the window
for
each and every one of us. And And I believe that his prayers have been answered. And so far that every one of them has confessed that the Lord has saved the soul, all the children. And now it's the grandchildren, there's just a few of us, but there's some more of us, there's 20-some of us. And I look for them all to hope to make that confession. Amen. Before they leave this world. Amen. At least leave a lively hope behind that we would know that they're in a far better place. It's a good consolation in the mind of us here, knowing that they have went home to be with Jesus. You know, I say I'd love to go home and be with my family. Yeah, we're all family. But I really want to go home and be with Jesus. Amen. For all the things that he's done for me, all the things that he has made a way since the beginning of this world. And I thank God that he sent his only begotten Son into this world to die for us. Into a world that was full of troubles and full of sorrows and full of hatred. There's a lot of hatred here. They are. And that's what's going on now. There's a lot of hatred, a lot of anger, a lot of jealousy in this world. And men are trying to find power within themselves to take down the goodness of the Lord. And I see that, and yesterday I was at a place and was picking up a sandwich and was standing there and talking to this other guy, and he was very nice, and these people, they were standing there and they was cussing, using their dirty fingers and all that stuff. And I finally felt that I wanted to look and say, where is your respect? Where is your love for this country? And you got children in the back of that truck, Doug, that they're looking up to. They're looking at the parents saying, you know, that's the way mom and dad is, that's the way we're, you know, that's the way we're going to be. And when I left there and I got to thinking, I said, so shall the days be like Noah. It'll be like Noah. And it's already here. It's already getting worse every day. Voila. I hope that you pray and ask the Lord to help me. I really didn't have anything on my mind. I'm just so thankful to be out here, be with my brothers and sisters, yes, most of all, and be able to see Abe, be able to see Virginia and all these brothers here, and be able to sit down together hear them sing and be able to rejoice and shout and give God the glory and honor. That's what we're here for. Yes. That's what we came in here to do, is give God the glory and honor in this life. That's what we was made to do when he put man in the garden, Brother Billy. That's what he wanted to do, is give him the honor. He gave man a garden, a beautiful garden, no doubt. Everything there to eat of that garden, except one tree. And we know that every time things good is happening, evil is also present somewhere along the line. Someone is getting upset or jealous. Someone is saying something just to hurt someone else. You know, that's why that he created man in his own image and put him in that garden. He bred into him a living soul. And then he told him and he made him a helpmate, Brother Dina. And died that the man for the woman and woman for the man. And Adam told him, die for this woman. She's the flesh of my flesh and the bone of my bone. So we know that God has set an example before us in this world. That is for a woman to be with a man, and for the man to be with the woman. Now that's just as plain and simple, and that was said before the foundation here, before all mankind. And I thought about, you know, when she was out in the garden, she was approached to Satan. You know, I was approached by Satan several times when I was lost and undone. How many times that he tried to keep me out, selling that dark world? You know, man loves darkness better than light. And I did the thing. I did, and things I told me, you're young, you got plenty of time in this life. Do what you want to do in this world. And I'm sure every one of you in this house, Satan has done something to you, has done something to keep you from enjoying the salvation. Yeah. Something to keep you from joining in the, from going into that life. Satan, when I was lost and undone, and I know that I come to church since I've been a little boy, this little church has been my home. It's always been my home here. You know, every people here in this little church, the light shine before me, even other places that I've been to. You know, Satan, he was there right there, and he said, well, look at them, how foolish they are. Yeah. You got all the time that you need. You're very young. You just need to enjoy this world and do things. Yes, I've done a few things in this world that my mom and dad wouldn't approve of, or no one wouldn't approve of. But by the grace of God, because of prayers by good old mom and good old dad, the angels watch over me. And they were the little conscience down inside of me that teach me right and wrong. Every time I done a little something, I felt guilty down in my soul. That I knew down in my heart that I was doing wrong. Oh, and I knew that they taught me that there's an age of accountability. And I know sometime in this life here, when I was young, I remember when I was standing in that seat, second row back. I'll never forget this. Oh, Brother Walter Aker was up here preaching, had that little book in his hand. Bless his heart today. When he was preaching about the salvation of Jesus Christ, there was something that appeared before me. There was a little light about him that appeared to me, and I knew that the Lord had showed me something about him up there. I knew at that age that I was doing right or wrong. Why, I could have turned my life to the Lord. At that time, I could have reached and hollered, Lord, they my soul, and things would be good, but I didn't do that because I'd let the darkness fit, and I did the light. But the Lord still works with me, and I'm glad by His love, His bound, His mercy, His love. How deep can it go? How high can it go? How wide can it go? But here's the thing about it, the Lord died upon the cross. He let those nails drove through his hand. As my brother Dina said, a friend that laid his life down. For every one of us, he didn't have to do that. When he hung up on the cross, he died for us. He didn't have to do that. When he bowed his head in this world, before he did that, he lifted up his head up into the sky. Into heaven, our Father, forgive those, for they know not what they done. They didn't understand, but it was the plan. I didn't understand everything the Lord had done for me. But when He came into my life, and when I was lost and undone, I realized now what the Lord had done for me. More and more every day that I get older, I begin to thank God. Seem like more and more, and the tears begin to flow down my eyes more, and because there's a love in me that'll never die.
There you go, sir.
Amen.
Oh, there's a love in me that will never die. I thank the Lord for everything that He's done. I thank Him for a little man like me that came here. I answer my prayers. How many things that I've done. Oh, He forgave me. He died to find me. He brought me up on a rock. Yes, I'll never be no man pluck me out of His hand. Oh, that he bowed his head and died for me. Yeah. I'm so glad that he laid in the tomb for me. Yeah. I'm so glad that he was from the grave. That third and fourth morning for me. Oh, when he told them, I gotta go away. And if I go, I'll come again. Oh, why did he have to leave? He had to leave to send another comforter. Oh, yes, sir. Bless that name. Bless that Holy Ghost. That Holy Spirit. Oh, the day when they was praying in the house, Dad. Oh, no doubt they were still heartbroken. Oh, they was looking for the Lord to come again. Oh, when he was talking about praying with one accord, with one mind and one accord. Oh, there was something happened that day. Oh, it came like a mighty wind running through the house. Instead of on fire, they spoke. Yes, there were people that didn't know what they were talking about. Oh, what kind of new one did they get a hold of? Jesus Christ, they got a hold of the Holy Spirit. They set them on fire. That's what it takes today. And it also made me think about Cornelia. Hey, good man. Hey, I want to say like a righteous man. I gave poor, gave almond to the poor. Yeah. Oh, the Lord knew him. He knew me too. Yeah. I ain't ashamed to him, and I came to him and said, Cornelius, Cornelius knew the Lord. I go tend for Simon Peter by the seaside. I'm not getting it too far, but it just made me thought about that. Peter, Simon Peter, and his dread came into the Cornelius and his household. They would die. What happened? He started talking about the goodness of the Lord. Preaching the gospel. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm not the Holy Spirit to go to them and to them.
Yeah. Look at the water.
Yes, sir. Save them. Taking the knife, the water.
Yeah, saying that they've received the Holy Ghost as well as us. Yeah.
And I thank God for everything that he's done.
Amen.
I thank God that he made a way that day. I really had on my mind running through the church doors, but they met me at the door outside. Time to take your time, don't get no hurry. You're still young, that's it. That's the very word that he's always told me. You're still too young.
Yeah.
You know, I calmed me down and came in here and sat down. Oh, bless your sister Margaret, kindness. She come and hug my neck. Oh, son, there's something about you. Did the Lord save your soul? I was almost like Peter. I was trying to keep quiet. But I knew there was something that they knew there. Oh, I'll never forget when I had to come up here to sing. I couldn't deny it. I couldn't have not come up here and sing. But when the Lord got a hold of me, I can't remember everything that I've done. Only thing the Lord told me, turn around, son. They was all there standing out. All I know was to tell him the Lord saved my soul. Oh, he brought me up on the road. I can't wait to get back to bow down before the king and give him my crown. He's more deserved than anything in this world. I'm unworthy. I'm just like old John when he's in that water. Oh, whose shoes are not worthy to last on. Yeah, you got one coming out of the wedding night. Who's mightier than I?
Yeah.
Who's mightier than I?
I
thank the Lord every day that he's given me. And I couldn't deny the Spirit. I can't deny the water. I had a desire. I actually wanted to hurry and get to the water that day, but they were dumb on my mind. Don't you want the whole world to see? But if I had to go to the lake, to the ocean, just for the world to see, that's what I wanted to do. I really wanted that. I wanted people to come and see. You know, I'll tell this, and I'm going to get out of the way. That's why I left here that day. Satan was waiting on me.
Yeah.
He's still waiting on me. And I was driving down the road. And he said, buddy, he said, you made the biggest mistake in your life. Hey, I bowed my head and started praying. I said, Lord, help me. How many witnesses do you need in his life when he said you so? Buddy, all I needed was that one.
Yeah.
Yes, I knew that he saved me. But old Satan, buddy, he'll get the best of you somehow, in some way. This flesh, he can't touch your soul. He didn't activate your flesh. And I pulled in the BP and got me a little gas and walked in. And I sat in online, reaching out, trying to get the money. Here comes this little woman up beside me, and she pat me on the shoulder. She said, sir, she said, would you pray for my grandbaby? Yeah. I said, yes. I said, I don't know what's going on, but I will. And I thank God that he sent you to me. And I knew right then that God would give me another little witness right there. Then all later down that road, that through that week, he was still dragging with me, trying to hang on everything to me. I said, Lord, help me. I want to do everything into this world to show this world how true that you are in me. So when I came Saturday here, we was having a little meeting, your little brother-in-law. But it's hard. I've had a dream tired that they were two people was coming somewhere along down the road. But that faded dream just went away. And here comes your brother-in-law. And then the old selling gate hall, they were three of us. I thank the Lord for everything that he done. To give me a witness down in my soul before the world that he can do all things. He can make all things. He'll make a way for you. I thank God for that. I thank God for all the things that he's done. I'll get out of your way. I love each and every one of you. Some
love you, brother.
Days, if we can't all do everything that God wants us to do here, I promise you, when we get there, we'll sit down at the same table. I was Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac. We'll sing that new song. I'll let the angels sing the same instead of joyful day. There'll be no man in paradise to tell us what we can do, because we got a king, a blessed Father on high, who's got a boundary that has no end to it. The love, it has no boundary to it. There's no ending to that love. And I thank God for that.
Amen.
Thank God for everything.
Amen. Well done. Okay, really.